I'm an acoustician. I study the acoustics of concert halls. I've done measurements in virtually all of the major concert halls in Australia. We use loudspeaker and we emit an impulse. And then we measure that response somewhere else in the concert hall. And from this, we create a whole lot of parameters which identify whether that concert hall is going to be really, really good or really, really bad. I actually studied undergraduate civil engineering, so I sort of got into the architectural side of things. And then I did an honours degree and I did a project in concert hall acoustics. And then I decided to turn that into a PhD. In undergraduate engineering, we have civil, electrical and mechanical. Acoustics is normally considered mechanical. I use a lot of civil in the design of buildings, but we use a lot of electrical in our measurements. Had a really good background in all three, and I use that knowledge all the time. Not that many people would go down this path after doing civil engineering. It's quite unusual. However, I think that when you study something like engineering, it's pretty easy to branch out into a whole range of different things. At UTAS, we study a very generic 18-month course where you don't have to select which one you want to do. It's one of the reasons why I studied at UTAS. Within the degree, you do 12 weeks of an industry placement. We do lots of laboratories, we do field trips, so there's a lot of real-world connection there. And when we do our honours project, most of those projects will have an industry link or a real-world link. So it's so easy to find out what you might be doing after you finish. If you have the degree, that's really all you need, and you can end up doing virtually anything. There's so many options for engineers, and it's one of those great careers where you'll always be able to find a job, and hopefully a job that you really, really enjoy.